Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you how I painted Hal and Sophie from Hal's Moving Castle. First of all, I just want to say that it's one of my favorite animes ever. I'm not really an expert in the genre, but I have some absolute favorites, for example Sailor Moon or Shaman King. Other than that, I like literally don't know anything about the genre. So Howl's Moving Castle is animated film by Hayao Miyazaki and Studio Ghibli. Studio Ghibli is well known for its own unique and beautiful aesthetic in making anime. So one of the interesting things about this anime is that it was actually based on the book of the same name by British author Diana Wynne Jones. I stumbled across this book by accident and I was like, oh my god, I am reading this. This book is really good, I think it's worth reading. It has a lot of differences in the plot. For example, there is no war theme in the book. Hal's main concerns are his love interests. It's also very interesting that in the movie Sophie didn't have any magical powers, unlike every other character, but in the book she is a witch, but practices her magic unconsciously. For example, she was able to put her magic in the hats that she made while working at the shop. Once she thought a hat that it would make a rich young man fall in love with the woman that bought it, and it actually happened. You may ask, what did the author of the book, Diana Jones, thought about this anime? Well, she loved it. To be honest, it's very hard not to. She was absolutely enchanted by the depiction of magical scenes, of the falling stars, the castle, demon Calcifer. Miyazaki even flew to England to give a private screening of the movie to the author. The castle itself bears a striking resemblance to Baba Yaga's hut. Baba Yaga is a character from Russian fairy tales, and the house that she lives in is a hut on chicken legs. So it is believed that that was an inspiration for the castle. It may be just a coincidence, but who knows? Hal's Moving Castle contains strong pacifism and anti-war themes. It was influenced by Miyazaki's distaste for the Iraq War. He recalled that he had a lot of rage about the war and decided to put it into the movie because he felt it would be poorly received in the United States. The movie also contains messages about feminism and old age. It sheds very positive light on growing old. It conveys the message that life is worth living at every stage. Also, it is very rare that you can see old women presented as protagonists and main characters. When Sophie becomes old, she gains a lot of confidence and feels more able to speak her mind. Sophie's actions are also considered to be kind and compassionate, but at the same time presented as being powerful and heroic. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my video, and I'll see you next time.